Hello everybody, I'm Dr. Neha Taneja. So in my last video, we spoke about the concept of chlorination, including free residual chlorine. Today we're going to discuss about chlorine demand. Now anybody can ask you a question that suppose we have a particular amount of water, say 1 litre, 2 litre, 2.5 litres, how much of chlorine or bleaching powder should you add into that amount of water to disinfect water? This concept or this demand is what is known as chlorine demand. What is the definition of chlorine demand? I've put it down for you. It is the amount of chlorine which is required to destroy bacteria and to oxidize all organic matter and ammoniacal substances in water. In other words, I told you it is just the amount of chlorine which is required, which will be required to disinfect a particular amount of water. Now we will see that how much chlorine is required to disinfect a particular amount of water. That can be calculated by an apparatus which is known as Horockks apparatus. Okay, so now we will basically see that how does this Horockks apparatus function. So Horockks apparatus consists of one black cup and six white cups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Indicator that is used is starch iodide. Now what happens is all these cups contain this water which is required to be disinfected. So this black cup and these are the white cups. Now in this black cup we add the amount of water which is required to be disinfected and we add starch iodide to it. So this starch iodide with this water will make a solution. So basically what is the work of this black cup? It is to prepare the solution. Now in all the white cups the water is already filled but at different levels. What we will now do is we will add 2 drops of this starch iodide indicator in each cup. Yes. Property of these cups that whenever one cup starts showing color change, all subsequent cups will also start showing color change. What does this mean? Suppose the first cup does not show any color change on addition of the indicator. The second cup does not show. Now if the third cup shows color change, automatically the fourth, fifth and sixth cups will show a color change. Which means that if one cup starts showing color change, the next cups will show color change. So now to calculate the amount of chlorine required, you need to remember a formula which is nothing but N into 2 grams of chlorine is required to disinfect 455 liters of water. Now what is the N here? N here is nothing but it is the cup which shows color change. Okay? Understand the concept better. I have put down a numerical for you. It shows how many grams of bleaching powder or chlorine is required to disinfect 1500 liters of water, where the fourth cup is the first cup to show color change in Horockks apparatus. Now whenever you get a question like this, I have told you for PSM, put down the formula. So formula is N into 2 grams chlorine required to disinfect 455 liters of water. So here what is N? The N is the fourth cup. So 4 into 2 will be 8 grams. So 8 grams is 455 liter. If you put it reverse, which is 455 liters is being disinfected by 8 grams of bleaching powder or chlorine. So how much 1500 liters would be disinfected by? Nothing but 8 in, by 455 into 1500. So that comes out to be something around 27. Okay, so this is very simple. You could be getting 4 options and you have to calculate it. Now, so question that comes is finally is what is the total amount of chlorine that should be added? Okay. Chlorine demand. Plus we had studied 0.5 milligram per liter of residual chlorine should be present in drinking water. So that is 0.5 gram per liter of free or residual chlorine. So total amount of chlorine that should be added to disinfect any amount of water is chlorine demand plus the amount of free or residual chlorine which is there. Okay, and last question that would be asked is, what is break point chlorination? So break point chlorination is nothing but the point when the chlorine demand of water is met. Okay, so I hope you got the concept of chlorine demand, free residual chlorine. This is for today's video. If you liked it, please comment and do keep sharing the video. Thank you.